So Texas can be very green. This is a lot of greenery around here. I appreciate it. Natural, doesn't need to be watered. Doing good in the winter time. Maybe it does more roughly in the summer. North of here is supposed to be a significant springs. And the water tastes good around here. So I'm sure that spring underground area is extending this far. Alright, so this was the main place I wanted to check out from the Walmart. Some homeless guys camping out on the tree line. Three of them. Three old guys. This is surprisingly populated. Is it that busy all the time, or is today a special day? They're parking in the grass, which is unusual. Alright, I walked by this house, the sprinkler turned on. I think there's some kind of motion sensor. It turned right off when I walked past. Listen. It didn't turn on. How does it... How does that work? I got sprayed on the road. It looks like there's a motion sensor. It turned on for 5 seconds. That was strange. Maybe it was manually turned on. A gosh darn sprinkler that turns on when you're within range. I didn't walk onto the property. It's got good water here. You know, something I find interesting is the cops pulled over that car that's driving, and those three cars backed in and just parked and waited out this cop involvement. You see the flashing lights. So I think there might have been a little drag racing or something. Yeah, the traffic on the highway is pretty impressive. It's pretty busy between San Antonio and Austin. Sure, Dallas too. You got those major cities, and this is a major road attaching all three together. Alright, so you can see how cheap Garmin or the History Channel is, because they share the same image for Nagelin's Bakery as they do for Grun Hall. Okay. So this is the image. Nagelin's Bakery has this image of Grun Hall. And then they say that's the bakery. And then you go back to Grun Hall. I'm doing this one-handed. To Grun Hall and New Braunsfel. And you got the same picture. Grun Hall. And now they're calling it the dance hall. So, and you think, okay, maybe they're on the same site. But no. Nagelin's Bakery is 1.4 miles north from my spot here. And then Grun Hall is 4 miles north, even further in the same direction. So, how cheap is that?
Where do I schedule an appointment?
Oh, okay, right here.
Here?
No,
okay.
Come with me.
Come with you?
Come with me. Actually, I won't come all the way with you.
Do I normally enter these doors to do that?
No, this is front door up here. This is where the shoppers exit back here.
This is an exit?
Yes.
Okay, all right, sorry.
When you break that dip.
free handouts or something, right? The fair.
Check in here?
We need to check in.
Are you here to see the fair?
I'm just looking.
Yeah, we'll check in and then you can go look around. There's prices.
There's what?
There's prices over there.
Prices?
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean prices?
We're giving away stuff.
Prizes. Oh, mm-hmm. See. Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm not like a part of this. I'm just looking.
No, it's welcome for everybody.
Okay, then I'll just walk in.
Yeah, but you have to sign in though.
Why? Why do you need my name?
You don't want to?
No.
Okay.
I think it's silly.
Hi there, do you need any help?
What do you help with?
We have job listings here.
Okay.
And then we have computers that you can
use. That's the two big things in this room? Mm-hmm. Jobs and computers?
Okay. Yes.
Alright.
And I don't know if you know.
Alright, the choices here are excellent. Very excellent. Very excellent. I didn't grab everything. My backpack is full. I'm going straight back to my car a mile and a half away. I unfortunately was not able to record the food choices. There was lots of frozen meats that they're giving me. They gave me a whole shopping cart of stuff. And I could only take like apples, oranges, and milk. I didn't know what to expect. I didn't drive over. I just exploratory. As soon as I show up, within 10 minutes, I got the food. And then I checked out like the food fair or something like that, but there's just too many people. It's a long line. They wanted me to sign in. I didn't want to. I only wanted to look, record what I could, I guess. And it's a very, very sophisticated food bank. It's been a long time since I've seen one, especially in Texas. That's the first, well, I'll just say it's the best food bank I've seen in Texas. But I bet that San Antonio one now is pretty darn good itself. But it just seems so out of the way for all the activity on the west side of San Antonio. I didn't want to stop and I didn't want to deal with all that traffic. New Braunsfel is a little more relaxed. So I can mosey over, check things out better. All right, this looks a little different. Molly. Recompense, $3,000. Oh boy, give them a call. Wow, Wisteria Lane, just like Desperate Housewives, trailer court edition. So Wisteria and Melody, those are pretty names. People live within their means, and they keep a clean profile. Very nice, even though they are living a little below their means, a little below the average. They're living very, very good. Very, very productively, keeping their yards clean and stuff. All right, I only have one hand for this, so this is the best I can do. That's Molly again, different sign. All right, another lost dog. Molly's been up, has a lot of signs. Black ears, tail, a large black spot. That's it. No contact information. Oh, please call. It's been up so long that the ink wore out. Disappearing ink. It is such a maze to get back to my car, running through the neighborhoods. I want to avoid all that nasty traffic, but that involves having to take a lot of twists and turns. They do not have straight roads in these neighborhoods, and that's good security, I think. You know, with all the Africans I hear singing when I walk by them, I'm thinking that's happening in Africa. That's their nature. I bet there's a lot of singing going on the streets in Africa from what I see in America. One side wanted me to tell that lady, that black lady, to shut it. But the other side wanted to say, you go, sister. I think it's my white side that wants. Then you got these guys. I can't tell people what to do like that. That's not right. Alright, so I did notice the no overnight parking sign in the Walmart. I got it right at the entrance. Kind of a small sign. So I walked this like 2 miles. I didn't want to ride the bicycle and break it. Can't handle much. Yeah. Oh yeah, cabbage and some really beat up peppers. These things have been sitting on the shelf for a long time. Oh yeah, the oranges, and then I might have made orange juice from all the pressure. Yeah, I'll be eating pretty good today. Alright, so the date is February 13th. And this milk expired January 30th. But it's not too bad. I really don't taste any problems. How about instead of when you're having a heart attack, instead of having just cayenne and warm water, what about cayenne and tomato paste? That'd be a combination. That's a heart saver, right? I don't know if I'll be able to find out. I think the closest I'd come to pizza these days would be this whole milk, tomato sauce, and bread. The healthy bread, of course. So the bread would be the crust. The sauce would be the middle part. And then the cheese you lay on that pizza would be the milk. And then sprinkle some of this in, because I am finding that this tomato sauce takes away the burning in my throat when I consume cayenne pepper somehow. So the cayenne pepper can actually, it's actually more tolerable with tomato sauce. All right, so I had this charity group approach me. It's kind of random, behind the Walmart. And he started telling me about the charity group a little bit, and I talked with him. It just makes me kind of angry that I get approached, because there's so many places there's an overflow of homeless people in much worse condition than me. This area is hard to find homeless people. And so then I get picked on, and it made me remark to him that there's definitely an imbalance, where sometimes some places have too few charity groups and too many homeless, and then other places that may have too many charity groups and not enough homeless. So they're out there looking. It's an imbalance. And there's not a lot of homeless here. You know what angers me the most about charity groups, and consistently does, is they can offer, a place to sleep and whatever programs. They never have any mailboxes for me, and they're worthless. All right, so the seats, it's Got some difficulties keeping screws on. I lost one screw, so, and I don't even recall. I think I probably did buy some of these before. I don't know where the others are. I'm sure I have some of these in the car somewhere. I'm gonna need to keep them somewhere that I can find them. But yeah, I'm constantly trying to screw them back in, and I didn't do it enough, and one fell out. So I looked for what I thought I was supposed to have, which I don't have any that I could find right away. So I just bought some more since I'm conveniently near the Lowe's behind the Walmart. So I come over here looking for the Goodwill donation station, and they're just advertising for the highway. It's actually this way. They advertised for the highway, and then the actual location is a little down the road more. I missed that sign. Stay in your car. This guy didn't stay in their car. Look at this. They lost their door, and it's a wreck. There's no selling. There's no money to make in selling tools at all here. All right, I'm not too happy about buying this $7 screwdriver, but it can be useful. This constantly needs to be screwed in. I usually do it by hand, but I could tighten it more with the screwdriver. Never really had something like this. I went over to Goodwill to get something used, but they got no tools. They see no business in tools. Where's Goodwill transporting their tools? You know they're getting donations of tools. They're not selling them at this store. So I bought a brand new screwdriver here. Let's see how this works. Part of the reason also why I had to buy this is because I did have a multi-tool I found. I acquired. Somebody left it laying around somewhere in a small town of Washington, in Washington. And then a few years later, my car gets broken into in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and I just put them all in there. I at least need one out. By a meth head, with no doubt, a meth head broke into my car and stole a lot of things. He focused on taking bags, my bag of clean clothes, quite a few bags, even a bag I sewed myself for my computer. He took it, and one of the bags had tools. I had a tool bag that I found somewhere in Phoenix. It had some pretty nice tools, and it was all stolen. So that's partly why I'm buying this. I held off a long time. That was over a year ago.